My name is Astrid Northrup, and I am currently Associate Professor of Engineering Science and Math at Northwest College.
Hello, I'm Michael Selmer. I was a small businessman in Laramie. I'm currently, in forced retirement because of illness.
Hi, I'm Shannon Cunningham. Been a teacher for 19 years. I currently work for Laramie County School District Number 1 at South High.
In the United States right now, we're not educating enough people to be scientists and engineers for the jobs that we need, so we end up outsourcing a lot. So I really kind of see it tied into the American dream and the American way of life.
There's just so much technology out there and so much new science and decisions that all adults are going to have to make, and so all adults need to be scientifically literate.
Even for people that don't go into a science-related field, critical thinking that science education teaches you can apply to all phases of your life. That's why I think that having the best science standards possible for our children is critical.
The first thing that we did was we looked at science standards of other states. My experience with that process was there's common ground, and I related that to the idea that the foundational principles of science were present in all of the good standards.
When I knew I was going to be on the state standards committee, they went around to the different communities, and so I participated in the Cheyenne one and just listened to all the stakeholders, listened to all the people that were there. They presented such a good spectrum of what they wanted in their science standards.
The different groups went through every single standard, line by line, to see how they related to our community, our local communities, and to our state overall. And I think we did a great job. I really believe that the standards do reflect our state.
Wyoming is unique, and yet science is universal. So how do we marry universal scientific principles and scientific inquiry and scientific thought to the specific nature of life in Wyoming?
Every single voice on that committee came to consensus on these standards. Every single standard was approved through consensus.
As a whole committee, we went through each line, every single sentence, and we all reached consensus on what we thought the best science standards for Wyoming were going to be.
They tell what the students should know when they graduate. They do not dictate curriculum or tell a teacher how to teach. And I think that's really important. Local control in Wyoming is one of the big issues.
I felt like teachers were being pushed toward teaching facts, because facts can be regurgitated on an exam. And we need to not turn kids off to science by making it rote and dry. In poorly executed science, it's like reading a text and picking out facts and learning ideas, not doing ideas, but learning what the paper says.
What goes through my mind is I want kids to actually be able to see a problem, be able to look at all the different pieces, be able to look at it with intelligence, and then be able to glean what are the important pieces, or how to solve the problem, or how to troubleshoot it, or just have a broad perspective of how to deal with some of the challenges that they're going to have to face.
One thing that strikes me is the use of the scientific method overall, which is examining data and developing a hypothesis and then perhaps developing a theory based on that hypothesis. Although we haven't, said, we're using the scientific method to develop the science standards. But I feel like we have done something very similar to that, where we've tried to eliminate our own biases. So I feel like the committee's done a pretty exceptional job of eliminating bias, whether it's political or popular opinion or economic.
As far as me personally, I had joined the committee. We had met for the first time, and right after that meeting, I was diagnosed with mantle cell lymphoma. And at the next meeting, I said, these standards are critical now for me personally, because it could be that 10 years from now, some graduate of Wyoming who's gone through with these excellent standards, might discover a cure for this.
It was worth it. I think we need to have really strong science standards for our state. And Wyoming really needs to look towards the future and how to make our kids incredibly scientifically literate.
If the science standards that we have written are implemented, I think that within a few years, we're going to see big returns as far as students' ability to do science. The 30 plus people on this committee have gone into this process with a lot of heart and a lot of dedication and with deep integrity and devotion to the idea of developing very good science standards for our students and also for the state of Wyoming. I hope that community people and outside observers will understand that we did not undertake this process lightly and that nothing was developed quickly or flippantly or without a lot of thought.
These standards will provide a roadmap through which our students will be career, college, and military ready.